Right, guys, JH. Just a little add-on to that, getting the club started on your backswing. Very windy here today. Very windy. About 25, 30 mile an hour wind straight into us. What happens when it gets windy and you try to hit, say, a driver? I noticed a lot of guys tend to lean on the ball because the wind's blowing on them, and they for some reason or other, they just tend to lean there and not make a good weight transference into the backswing. Well, guys, that little bit that I did in the other video showing you how to start the backswing, absolutely invaluable. Invaluable with the driver. Because with the driver, the last thing you want to do is leave your weight too far left into the wind, because that'll make you bleep down on it very, very steeply, put too much spin on the ball. You want to make a full turn to the right, get in behind the ball, and be able to launch it with some low spin. And again, I wanted to show you this new super light Wilson Staff D100. I think this is the one Patrick Harrington hit 369 the other day. Fantastic low spin driver, super light. The whole golf club is about 75 grams lighter than a Taylor or a Callaway. So guy, here it is, same thing. Five level in the grip, we're going to bleed it out. Going to feel the head, and we're just going to turn that right hip. These are great clubs. You know, the club, or just the rank and file golfer these days is so lucky, because no one makes bad clubs anymore. I wouldn't play the old style golf clubs for money. Why would I? These are too easy to hit. I've got a set of Tommy Nakajima's irons, the old Mizunos. They belong to Tommy. I brought them out here the other day and hit them, blades, and they're beautiful golf clubs. Rubbish compared to this stuff. Wouldn't use it. Why would you use it? Here we go. Watch this, guys. So I'm feeling it. Five, four. I've got to tell you, guys, this could be the straightest golf club I've ever hit. That's only about the sixth drive I've hit with it. I hit a couple off camera. And it's so windy here today. And it's a head crosswind, and they're just dead straight into the wind. But you see how I'm just getting that weight into that right side? I'm getting this going first. Almost feels like the club is getting lagged like that, which is not a bad thing anyway. This being an old dude like I am, this is just fantastic to have a golf club that's so light, and those irons are so light. I think the shafts in them are only 65s. I think the shaft in this is only a 50 or a 48. Head only weighs 184. I put my own leather grips on them, but which are a bit heavier than they want on them, but I just like those grips. But boy, it just swings itself. And a bit softer, it's just a normal stiff. But it doesn't feel heady. It's fantastic. Okay, we'll see if we can really get those hips really work quick to the right. Guys, on the JH practice tee under these conditions, that's the best shot I've ever hit. Into that wind. I mean, these are fairway finders. Get out and get yourself one of these. Wilson Staff D100 Super Light. Just go and have a hit with them. You will be impressed. I had the latest Taylors here yesterday, the new Taylors. New Generation 2 BRZ. Didn't like them. I think they've ruined the golf club with the new shaft they put in. Those new R1 drivers are terrible. They've got no feeling. They don't go. This thing's 20 yards longer. I mean, I've got them over there, I wouldn't even hit them. I just don't like the feel of them. Watch this. turn that hip. Can't miss, guys. Can't miss. Or I'll try and make a huge body turn on the backswing. That's what I'm thinking about, just turning the hip. My arms have to follow. My body's leading, not my hands. My body's instigating the backswing. I'd love to hit this club downwind or with no wind. Wow. And guys, a good looking head. Nothing fancy, none of those adjustable crap and rubbish that they have. I hate that. I don't feel a good, think a golf club feels any good with that hosel in there that's all adjustable. These have got that really crisp hit on the ball type feel. Big body turn. Guys, I ain't never going to come down. Never. I mean, that's prodigious from the end of that wind. Absolutely prodigious. This is basically a test day for Wilson with the clubs while I'm here. But guys, the same thing happens. Okay, watch with the iron. Okay, we'll just hit a 5-iron. And I'll try and get as much hip activation early on, which I normally don't do. I normally connect up and I usually just push all this away. And that usually pushes my hip into submission. But this way, I'm getting my hip going in and I feel my hands being pulled into the shot. Shafts or what, but these clubs are so straight. A little bit hard to time for me because I'm not used to them being so low. Okay, we'll really bust this one. Really good shot. It's a little rough on the timing, these shafts, and this golf club, but all those golf balls are in a 10-yard circle, every one of them. And every one of them was hit slightly different. So we'll really get this one. I've just got to lag it a little because the shaft's a bit softer than I normally use. Killed that. Okay, guys, have a look at that.